This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. All right, this is our third problem, solving a right triangle. And I'm not drawing a picture this time. I'm just giving you one of the angles and one of the sides. Solve the right triangle if B, the angle B, is 32 degrees and C is 12.3. So we have to think how we want to draw this. And usually C is always the hypotenuse, the side opposite the right angle. So let's get a little picture of what this looks like. So we've got an angle B, it's 32 degrees. So it's a small angle, right? So let's say that's B and that's A. And then this would have to be C. That means this length C has to be up here at 12.3. So if you want to look at the picture. And then B is 32 degrees. So we need to find A, B, and C, the angles, and A, B, and C, the sides. And let's fill in what we know already. All right, we're given that angle B is 32 degrees, so we know that already. And we know C is the right angle, so that's 90 degrees. We also know that side C is 12.3. All right, so we need to find two sides. We need to find side A and B, and we need to find angle A. All right, that's going to be the easiest one, angle A, because A plus B have to add up to 90 degrees. All right, so if A and B add up to 90 degrees, A must be 58 degrees. You could just do 90 minus 32 to get that answer. All right, now how about we need to find either side A or side B. So let's label these over here. Side A, I'm going to say, will be the side opposite, right? And side B will be right here. So I have to think about using what I already know, right? An angle that I already know. So how about I'm going to use angle B. And I also want to use this side here, this 12.3. Well, that happens to be the hypotenuse of the triangle. And to find A, well, that's an adjacent side to angle B. So I have to think, what trig function will use the adjacent side and the hypotenuse? And that would be the cosine. So the cosine of B, or in this case 32 degrees, has got to be A over the hypotenuse, which is 12.3. So this is just an equation with a one variable missing. And so to solve for A, we can multiply both sides by 12.3. So I would have 12.3 times cosine of 32 degrees, and that will give me my side A. So we could do that in the calculator. So go ahead and get out your calculator and put that in. Make sure it's in degree mode. So we want to do 12.3 times the cosine of 32 degrees. And let's go ahead and round this to the nearest tenth. I came up with 10.4. So I've got that A is approximately 10.4. So I'm going to write that up here. A is approximately 10.4. I'm going to use it. All right, now be careful. To find B, you might want to use the Pythagorean Theorem. But if you want to use the Pythagorean Theorem, you can't use 10.4. You'd actually have to square this whole thing, 12.3 times the cosine of 32 degrees. You don't want to use anything rounded to figure out that answer. So let's do it a different way. How can I use the 32 degrees and find B? That happens to be the side opposite, right, to 32 degrees, and I could use the 12.3, which was given. I could use the sine. So the sine of 32 degrees will be the side opposite, which is B over 12.3. So by the same method we solved to get A, we're going to multiply both sides by 12.3. So B is going to be equal to 12.3 times the sine of 32 degrees. And again, we're going to just put that in our calculator and get our approximate answer. So you want to put in your calculator 12.3 and then the sine of 32 degrees. And I've got that to the nearest tenth, 6.5. So I'm going to go up here and I'm going to say B is approximately, because I did round, 6.5. Now the first thing I'm going to do is make sure the smallest angle is opposite the smallest side. And yes, 32 is the smallest angle, 6.5 is the smallest side. 90 degrees is the biggest angle, C is the biggest side. That means the middle one also has to be true. 58 degrees, the middle angle, and that is the middle side. Okay, so that seems reasonable. So let's go ahead and check by doing the Pythagorean Theorem and see if we are close, if we're in the ballpark here. So the question is, we're not going to get it exact because we did round, but let's just check what's 10 squared, let's see, not 10 squared. What's 10.4 squared plus 6.5 squared, all right? So do that in your calculator. Do 10.4 squared. Oops, I'm doing it with you. 10.4 squared plus, and we're going to do 6.5 squared. And I come up with 150.41. And now see, is that close to 12.3 squared? Right? That's the question. Is a squared plus b squared close to c squared? It's not going to be exact because we rounded our answers. So if we do 12.3 squared, I get 151.29. So the main thing for you to realize is, yes, it's close, so these rounded answers look to be like we've gotten the right answer. Now, you could have, by the way, like I said, if you wanted, you could have plugged this in for A and used the Pythagorean Theorem. So if you wanted to find B a different way, right, without using the sine of 32 degrees, let's just see how that would have gone down. All right, when we just did it this previous way, we found that B was 6.5. Now, we found out that A was exactly 12.3 cosine of 32 degrees, and we know that C was exactly 12.3. So another way to find B is to use the Pythagorean Theorem. We know that A squared plus B squared is C squared, right? So if I'm going to solve for B before plugging in the numbers. So B squared is C squared minus A squared, right? Which means B is the square root of C squared minus A squared. So if you wanted to use your calculator, you would have to put in the square root. C is the 12.3, so you have to do 12.3 squared minus 12.3 cosine of 32 degrees. Square that. So if you want, what you could do is first just do 12.3 squared, then subtract this thing squared, and then take the square root, however way it works for you, and then you're going to take the square root. Make sure that you get approximately 6.5. And I did come up with about 6.5. Right, so that's an alternate way to do it. I think it's easier doing it the way I did it, but if you want to use Pythagorean Theorem, you do have to put this exact answer in. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.